This is Spartan Commander, and this is the 515th Rome Total War Brotherhood game that I've put onto YouTube. Straight away you'll see this battle was fought on a custom map, and this battle was hosted by Brotherhood member Crypto. It's always nice to play on custom maps, I think, rather than the normal usual ones that we play on. Okay, our first teammate is Brotherhood member Crypto, who has unusually bought the Macedon faction. Now Crypto has got 9 pikes, 6 cretans, and 5 cavalry. Okay, so I think that's quite a balanced army there. As I say, he doesn't usually bring Macedon very often, so I think he's a pretty good army there. And if you see there, he's only got gold shield, gold attack on his companion cavalry there. So I think that's a pretty good balanced army there. And our next teammate is Brotherhood member Spearman. Now Spearman has got 11 infantry, 2 archers, and 6 cavalry. Okay, quick look at the upgrades on his cavalry. And you can see he's got 8 upgrades, 2 experience stripes, gold shield, gold attack. We know this cavalry, as we've seen in the past, does really well with just gold shield, gold attack, but you put 2 experience stripes on it and that kind of makes it almost super cavalry there. So I think that's a pretty good balanced army of spearmen's there. Okay. Our next teammate is a Brotherhood member, AURELIUS. Now AURELIUS has got 11 infantry, 3 archers and 6 cavalry. But he's got quite an unusual army build here, which I think you might find interesting. So let's have a closer look. Okay, you'll see here that he's got 2 eagle units. Okay, there's one there. And as you can see, that one eagle unit there and the other one there. But these are early legionary cohorts, okay, so their defense isn't very high, so my guess is he won't commit them to battle unless he really has to. Okay, but of course they still give good morale to his troops. Plus, if you notice here, he's got hastastai, light infantry, which will probably be used in his pilar shield units. And I just think to myself, well, as long as they soak up pilars, why not use them instead of more expensive units? So he's got hastati there as his pilar shield units. But look at the upgrades on his urban cohort. 7 upgrades. Okay, that's an experience stripe, gold shield, gold attack on his urban cohorts. So if you look at that army there with 2 eagle units, okay, the general morale bonus they'll also be getting, plus the upgrades on those urban cohort as well. That is a pretty good infantry there, and I think that's going to fight for a long time there with all the morale that infantry's got. Let's have a quick look at the upgrades on his cavalry, and you can see that he's got 7 upgrades on his cavalry and experience stripe, gold shield, gold attack. Okay, so I think that's a pretty good balanced army there. Should be interesting to see how well that infantry does during the course of the battle. And our last teammate is myself, Spartan Commander, who's got a very old Greek city's army of 16 Spartans and 3 of the cheap short-range archers there. So there's our team. It's got the potential to be a great battle, and I hope you enjoy it. And here is the other team. We have OTD Baron. Now, Baron has got 11 infantry, 3 archers, and 6 cavalry. Okay, 11 infantry, 3 archers and 6 cavalry. Quick look at the upgrades on his infantry. Can you see he's got 7 upgrades on his infantry? An experience stripe, gold shield, gold attack. Okay, now that experience stripe really does make a difference, especially towards the end of the battle. And you can see his actual infantry general has got 8 upgrades. So that's 2 experience stripe, gold shield, gold attack. Now that experience stripe really does help that infantry, you'll see during the course of the battle. And you notice here he's just got gold shield, gold attack on his cavalry there. Okay, so that's an interesting arm build, and as I say, that experience stripe on his infantry, you'll see, will come into its own during the course of the battle. Okay, their next teammate is Brotherhood member Barclayman. Now, Barclayman has got 12 Sacred Band Spearmen, 6 Cavalry, and 2 Slingers. Quick look at the upgrades on his Cavalry there. You can see that he's just got 7 upgrades on his Cavalry as an Experience Stripe, Gold Shield, Gold Attack there. Okay, their next teammate is Brotherhood member Uther. Now, Uther has got 15 Sacred Band Spearmen and 3 Slingers, and it is very, very unusual to see Uther bring the Carthage faction. Should be interesting to see how well he does. Look at the upgrades on his Spearmen. 8 upgrades, 2 Experience Stripes, Gold Shield, Gold Attack. We know these Carthage Sacred Band men are really tough, but you put those type of upgrades on them, and that kind of makes him super tough there. I like the formation that he's using as well, but as you can see, he's got no cavalry. Okay, no cavalry in that army, so he's really gone heavy on the spears. That's why he's put so many upgrades on them. Okay, and their last teammate is Brotherhood member Trajan. Now, Trajan has got the bog standard 31k Roman army of 14 infantry and 6 cavalry. Okay, the reason that that's a bog standard 31k Roman army is because it's so effective and so efficient. So, now a bit of a question for you here. Do you think that either team has got a faction advantage here? Okay, so the enemy team there, as you can see, has got Rome, Carthage, Carthage, and Rome. Okay, so that's the enemy team there. And our team has got Greek cities, Rome, Rome, and of course Macedon. So do you think that either team here has got a faction advantage, or do you think it's going to be quite even? It's got the potential to be an absolute classic battle, and I hope you enjoy it. Okay, at this very, very early stage of the battle here, before we even set up, can you see OTD Baron running his archers forward here? He was hoping to catch my Greek cities moving over to my allies. Now, if I just set up right on the forward line of my setup area, he may well have been able to get me with his archers before I could go back to my allies, but because I always set back further from the front line there to avoid being lightning attacked like that, that's why he's not running forward anymore. He, as I say, he was probably hoping he was going to be able to catch my Spartans moving there, but luckily there, as I set back further from the front of my setup area there, he won't be able to do that. That was a nice cover there by Aurelius. You notice he had his cavalry there to cover for any cavalry attack that might have come in on me as well. So that's a nice bit of teamwork there by Aurelius. Okay, but as I say, you can see the SPQR OTD Baron there moving his archers forward. And if we move over right over here from the right flank to our left flank here, where our Macedonian ally is, you can see Crypto's already got his archers there. Notice he's got them in close, tight formation there for more impact and more damage. And he's starting to target the Carthage slinger units there. But he is a little bit exposed to cavalry there, so he needs to watch out for that. You can see that the enemy Scipii general there is moving his infantry towards his Macedonians. Remember, Trajan's army there is the basic 31k Roman army of 14 infantry and 6 cavalry. And you can see him moving here towards Crypto. He just loves to throw his pilers into those Macedonians, I bet. And you can see here that Uther is moving his Balearic slingers forward here to target the Macedonian archers, I'm guessing. Or he could target the Macedonian pike. Remember, those 120-man units are very susceptible to missile damage. As you can see here, there's a slingers in action. These guys have got a lot of slingshots to be able to sling at the enemy. They certainly get more slingshots than the archers do. Okay, can you see Spearman's cavalry moving forward here to threaten those Balearic slingers? If you notice here, can you see Spearman's got his cavalry in open order as he runs forward there? And the reason he's got them in open order is to avoid missile damage as much as he can. Remember, in RTW, if you've got your units in open order, they tend to suffer less damage from missiles. So that's why he's done that. Here you can see Crypto moving his cavalry forward in a very threatening manner here. For a second there, I thought he was going to smash into those Scipii infantry, but then decided to pull them back there. But that's a nice little tactic, though. You know, keep the enemy guessing what you're going to do, so they can kind of only react to you. As I say, you can see Crypto's archers there will be targeting the enemy units on here on the left flank. Now, over here on the right flank, you can see OTD Penn with his SBQR army there. Now, OTD Penn can be a very aggressive and attacking player. And I think it'll be interesting to see what happens over on this right flank. Now remember, we looked at his army earlier, and he's got extremely good upgrades on his infantry. As I say, it'll be interesting to see how well he does over on this right flank here. As I say, you can see Crypto here with his archers there. I think he was targeting the Carthage Balearic slingers there with his archers. But I noticed that he does tend to target infantry as well with those archers, and he seems to cause some casualties with them as well. Okay. So as you can see here, there's a general overview of the battle as it stands at the moment, at the very, very early stage of the battle here. And it'll be interesting to see which flank kicks off first. It's got the potential to be an absolutely epic battle. Okay, at this stage of the battle here, you can see OTD Penn with his SBQR army doing a right flanking action here around our ally Aurelius' army there. Okay, now remember, as I said earlier, we looked at OTD Penn's infantry during the setup, and you can see that I think each of his infantry has got an experience stripe on here. Now, as I say, you'll see him doing a right flanking action here, and as the battle continues, you'll see that that experience stripe will be very useful to him over here on the right flank, okay? But newer players to Rome Total War, can you see what he's doing here with this right flanking action? He's actually isolating himself here. Can you see how far away his allies are from his SBQR army here? Right, you can see some cavalry tussle going on here. See his SBQR cavalry going in there? And bang, as they smash in there. My guess is that Aurelius will pull his Julio cavalry back, which he's done. But you can see OTD Penn here being very aggressive, very attacking on this right flank here. This right flanking aggressive attack here, as I say, is really, really aggressive here. But you can see that he is definitely isolated from his allies there. Okay, now are we going to make the most of that? Are we going to try and hit him with our cavalry and infantry and try and smash him? We'll just have to wait and see. Okay, but over here on our left flank, you can see there's some Carthage Sacred Band cavalry and some enemy Scipioi cavalry here looking to come over here and try and take out our Macedonian allies' cavalry. Okay, you can see Crypto charging his cavalry in there, and bang, as he charges in there, the Carthage Sacred Band cavalry counterattacks, and bang, as they smash in there as well. I can see there's another Carthage Sacred Band cavalry unit going to hit into the flank, two of them there, into the flank of our Macedonian ally. Bang, as they charge in there. I think that Macedonian Companion Cavalry is holding extremely well there against that Carthage Sacred Band Cavalry. If he can just hold on there, our allies, Julii Cavalry, are on their way over here to help our Macedonian ally there. And that is a heck of a lot of cavalry coming in over there. Here comes the Julii Cavalry, get ready for this. And bang, as they smash into that Carthage Sacred Band Cavalry there. Nice assistance here. Great teamwork here by our Julii ally there to help our Macedonian ally out there. Look at all that Julii cavalry smashing into that enemy cavalry there. As I say, nice lot of assistance, nice lot of teamwork there. Good battlefield awareness there by both Aurelius and Spearman getting over to this flank to help our Macedonian ally. Right, but as you can see over on our right flank here, OTD Baron being extremely aggressive and attacking here on our right flank. But as I say, look how isolated he is from his allies. But remember, he's got the 7 upgrades on his infantry. Now look at the pilot exchange going in there between, I think, is it Spearman's army and OTD Penn's army there. A lot of pilot exchange going on there. But as you can see, the enemy SBQR general is definitely isolated from his allies. And we have spotted this, and we're going to be looking to go over there and try and hit him with a lot of our infantry and cavalry there to try and take him out. Okay, it's okay being aggressive and attacking there, but if you get isolated from your allies, you can very often be taken out, and that can change the course of the battle. Make no mistake, we have noticed that he's very isolated there, and if you notice, we're moving our troops over towards him because we're going to look to take him out on this right flank. Okay, you see Spearman's cavalry moving over there. You've got Aurelius's cavalry chasing down Carthage's Sacred Band cavalry. But if we all come over here with our cavalry and infantry, we will take out OTD Baron. It looks like he's backing off a little bit. I think he can see what's coming. Okay. You can see Uther moving his Carthaginians forward. I think he'd like to try and maybe get in contact with our Macedonian ally. You can see Trajan's Scipioi troops there in Testudo at the moment. But as I say, over here on the right flank, this could be the make or break of the battle here. Okay. You see, I think, as I say, Baron could see what's coming towards him here. He can see we're moving our troops and cavalry over here, and he decided to back off a little bit. But look, he's still so isolated from his allies there. And as I say, we've spotted that, and we will be looking to move a lot of troops over here to try and take him out. Okay, but I think he's doing a good move here. It's a good strategic move in here of a strategic withdrawal. Because, as I say, I think he could see what was coming there. Okay, a nice little move here by Barclayman, with one of his rallied cavalry units there chasing down some of my cheap archers. So that's a nice little move there by him with it cavalry. But over here you can see Trajan, Scipio, cavalry charging into our Macedonian allies' archers there, and bang as they charge into those Cretan archers there. Nice hit there by Trajan. He could take out all of our Macedonian allies' archers there if we're not careful. So as I say, that's a nice nice hit there by Trajan's Scipio cavalry. Let's just pause the game for a second here. So if we move over to the right flank here, can you see the OTD Pen has pulled his SBQR army back? He could see what was coming. Now Aurelius here, you've got Aurelius there, and I think he's going to be a blocker. And you can see Spearman's infantry and cavalry are all moving over to this right flank. Okay. Plus you've got some of our Macedonian allies, cavalry, companion cavalry over here as well. Okay, because we're looking to hit the enemy SBQR army here on our right. Now, what we want to do is stop any reinforcements getting over to the SBQR general. So I think Aurelius is going to act as a blocking force there. Okay, you can see Uther maybe looking to come in, charge into our Macedonian ally there. But as I say, over here on our left flank, you can see that Scipio cavalry really charging into our Macedonian allies' archers there. I see Cryptos there bringing some of his pike units over there to try and protect his archers. Okay, but meanwhile, over here on our right flank, let's say the SBQR general still moving back a little bit. Okay, he's going to be aggressive with his cavalry here. Look. Bang, as he charges in there with his cavalry. Let's say, look at his army movement. He's moving further and further away from his allies there. He must be extremely confident with his army. Okay, but as I say, remember, we looked at his army earlier there. And as I say, we've got to try and block any reinforcements getting over. So Aurelius is going to be the blocking force there, stopping any Carthaginian or Scipio reinforcements over to the enemy SBQR general. Okay, so that's what Aurelius' job is going to be there, to block as a blocker. And I think it's Spearman. It's going to try and stop Spearman with Aurelius' cavalry and his own cavalry here are going to try and hit the enemy SBQR army over on our right flank, okay? Plus our Macedonian allies got his companion cavalry there as well. So remember, Aurelius is going to be the blocker, and Spearman with Aurelius' cavalry and Macedonian cavalry there are going to try and hit the SBQR infantry over here on our right flank, okay? But as I say, you can see that the enemy SBQR general is extremely isolated here, and we've got to try and make the most of that. Okay, so as you can see, Spearman's bringing his infantry over there. We've got our cavalry locked and loaded. If you notice here, I'm moving my Greek city units over a little bit this way as well. See our allies' cavalry charging in there. Bang, as they smash into the SBQR cavalry there. Okay, so we've got a heck of a lot of our cavalry charging there. Spearman's got his infantry charging in there as well. This is a real tussle here. As I say, we want to take out the enemy general here, this SBQR general on our right flank. But remember, we looked at the upgrades of his infantry. Remember, he's got an experience stripe on all of his infantry there. So they are going to hold there. Can you see here, Spearman's charging his infantry, and we've got our cavalry charging in there as well. We got some very battle-damaged Macedonian cavalry in there that has just routed. As I say here, Aurelius is going to be a blocker to block any reinforcements getting over to the SBQR general there. So we just need to try and take out the SBQR general before they try and get over to us. I got my Greek cities army there will also be a blocker as well. If they try and get in between Aurelius and myself, I will attack. And of course, we've got our Macedonian ally there moving over to our right flank as well. Okay, so there's a general overview of the battle as it stands at the moment. Our Macedonian ally may even take his spears over to the right flank to help finish off the enemy SBQR general. Okay, But as I say, don't forget that, as I said earlier, the SPQR general's got a stripe on all his infantry, and that will keep his troops fighting longer. Plus his general, if you remember, had 8 upgrades on, 2 experience stripes, gold shield, gold attack. So his troops are going to get a lot of general morale bonus here as they're being attacked. I say, I think we've got all our cavalry there attacking the enemy SPQR infantry and cavalry. Plus, you've got spearmen's infantry going in on him as well. And still, the SPQR general's holding. Now, I'd have thought that might have been a mass rout there, but remember that experience stripe on his infantry really will help to keep his troops fighting longer. Plus, his general morale bonus there. And look at that, you can see our Julio troops are almost engulfing the SPQR troops there. And still, the SPQR infantry is holding there. I remember in this battle we were all thinking to ourselves, why isn't he dying? Why isn't he dying? We're trying to throw everything we got over there. And of course here, can you see that the enemy's Scipioi general has brought his cavalry over here. It looks like he's going to charge into the back of our engaged Julii infantry there. You can see that Scipioi cavalry charging in. You can see our Julii cavalry charging into the SPQR infantry and bang! And then the Scipioi cavalry charging in and bang! As they smash in there as well. Okay, so as you can see here on our right flank, that SPQR infantry is holding extremely well. And as I say, you've got enemy Scipioi cavalry charging in there as well to assist him. So as I say, we were expecting there, you can see the general still alive. We were expecting that SPQR infantry to have cracked by now. But as I say, that experienced stripe's keeping them fighting longer. Unfortunately, our Macedonian ally has lost his general there. Now remember, Macedonian morale is not very good anyway, and to lose his generals could be a bad thing for us. You can see both Uther and Barclayman moving forward with their spears. And you've got, as I say, Trajan's Scipioi troops moving forward as well. But over here on our right flank, we would have expected to have taken out that enemy SPQR army by now with everything we've hit it with. And yet it's still holding. So really well done there to the SPQR general. As I say, he's got a bit of support there from his Scipioi ally throwing those cavalry in. But with all the cavalry that we've thrown in there, plus all of Spearman's infantry, and we still can't break this SPQR army on our right flank. Now, as I say, you can see our Macedonian ally bringing his pikes over. Okay, I think we thought, as I say, the SPQR army would have broken by now. So we're having to bring Macedonian pikemen over as well to help all our cavalry and infantry against this SPQR army there. So that just goes to show what an experienced stripe can do for your army there. They held extremely well there. Okay, you can see Uther here looks like he's chasing our Macedonian ally. I think he wants to take on the Macedonians. Remember that Carthage punches above its weight when it comes to these big 120 man units, and they can do very, very well against the Macedonian long pikemen there. Okay, even though Carthage have only got short spears, their specifications are very good, and as I say, they do punch above their weight against these big 120 man units. And you can see here Uther really pushing in on our Macedonian ally there. You can see I'm moving my Greek cities army back there a bit. Oh, finally we've managed to take out the enemy SPQR general. Okay, so that's good news for us. We've managed to take out the general, but there's still a couple of SPQR infantry units left even now. So anyway, that's good news for us that we've managed to finally take out most of the SPQR army that was on our right flank. Okay, now I can see that Uther here was really trying to push in on my Macedonian ally. So I now move my Greek cities army over to this part of the battlefield, and I will now aggressively attack those Carthage Sacred Band units with my Spartan units there. Okay, plus we got our allies, Julii infantry coming in there as well. And don't forget we've got our Macedonian ally there with his long pikemen there pushing in at the same time. Okay, so there's a lot of pressure on Uther's Carthage Sacred Band units there. Okay, let's just pause the game for a second. So we got Aurelius here pouring in there. I've got my Greek city units there. And of course we've got our Macedonian ally there pushing in on those Carthage Sacred Band units. Okay, so a lot of pressure on Uther there. You can see nice little move there by Crypto there, moving pikes in behind the Carthage Sacred Banner. You've got Spearman's infantry there. He may well try and counter Barclayman's Carthage Sacred Band units, stop them moving into the rear or flank of our attacking troops. And of course you've got all of Trajan's infantry there. My guess is he may well come around the flank and attack us from behind there with his Scipioi troops. But as I say, we've mostly routed the SPQR troops on our right flank, but he's still got a couple of cavalry units left, and his archers have been shooting into us mercilessly all the time as well. So they say we were really relieved to see our right flank manage to break that SBQR army. It took a lot to do that, but that's what an experienced stripe on your infantry can do for you. Okay, so as I say here, you can see my Greek cities really pushing in to the Carthage Sacred Band units. We've got our Julyite ally and our Macedonian ally all pushing in on there as well. Okay. You can see, I think it's Spearman throwing a lot of pilers into that, into Barclayman's Sacred Band infantry there. And it looks like we've taken out, I think it's Uther's general here. So that's good news for us. But as you can see here, Barclayman's Carthage Sacred Band are pushing into our flank. As I say here, wouldn't surprise me if Spearman attack them to try and counter that attack. Maybe get some units in behind them. You can see he's throwing a lot of pilers in there. But I think a good tactical move there would be get some units in behind those Carthage Sacred Band units, as well as maybe trying to counter the Scipiae infantry coming in on our left flank there. Okay, you can see my Greek cities really pushing forward into the enemy Carthage Sacred Band there, along with my Julyite and Macedonian allies there. Okay. Okay, so you can see the enemy Trajan Scipiae army there throwing pilers into our allies' Julyite army there. A lot of pilot exchanging going on there between the two of them. So it'll be interesting to see what happens at this particular part of the battlefield, as the Scipiae infantry seems to outnumber our Julyite ally there. Right, here's Spearman's cavalry charge into the rear of those engaged Carthage Sacred Band, and bang, as he smashes in there. Nice nice hit there by Spearman there with his cavalry. Really well done there. And as I say, he's moving some units in behind the engaged enemy Carthage Spearman as well. So that's a nice move. As I say before, in other battles, why try and break down a barricaded front door when if you nip round the back, you might find the back door open, if you see what I mean. Right, you can see my Spartans there moving forward into the enemy Scipiae troops there. As you know, I'm always very aggressive with my Greek cities unit. I know that I've put my team at a cavalry disadvantage, so I've got to make up for that. And the only way to make up for that is to be aggressive with my Spartans. And as you can see, that's exactly what I'm doing there, moving into that enemy Scipiae infantry. And so you can see Barclayman here with his Sacred Band Spearmen. He had good upgrades on those Sacred Band Spearmen, and they're very tough infantry, as we know. And he's fighting Aurelius. Now remember, Aurelius has got some light cavalry, light infantry. There's Hastati. Plus, he's got those early legionary cohorts. As I say, you don't really want to commit those to battle unless you really have to against elite infantry like he's fighting here. If Aurelius' infantry cracks there, they can then get in behind us there and attack my attacking Spartans there. As you can see, I've changed the direction of my attack now. I'm starting to move down those Scipiae troops now. I'm moving down the line there, trying to take out Scipiae units as I move down that line. But as I say here, you can see, I think some good movement by a Spearman here attacking the rear of engaged Sacred Band infantry there. Nice move by him. But I don't like to see what I'm seeing here. I can see a lot of our Julyite allies units starting to rout here. As I say, I'm moving my Spartans into those enemy Scipiae troops there. And that OTD Baron's still using cavalry units, very battle damaged cavalry units, to attack our units there. Is a Carthage Sacred Band cavalry unit coming in. Bang! I think he's going for our Julyite allies general there. But as you can see here, a lot of our allies Julyite infantry are being routed here. There's an SBQR cavalry, bang, smashed in there. Now as I say, you can see a lot of our Julyite allies infantry starting to rout here from that massive attack there by the Carthaginians. Okay. So things not looking very good here with our Julyite allies there. Plus, they say you've got OTD Baron's battle damage cavalry. He's using them extremely well. Plus, you've got Trajan's infantry in there as well. So as I say, it's not looking very good for our Julyite ally there, losing a lot of his infantry here. And as I say, you've got several enemy cavalry units left. I think we've lost all our cavalry at this stage. As I say, you can see me moving my Greek cities in towards the enemy Scipiae troops there. You can see Trajan there charging units into the rear of my attacking troops. As I say, you see OTD Penn still got a cavalry unit there he's using very aggressively to attack our battle damaged units. Okay, so remember, we are the Macedonians, the Red Julii and Greek cities, okay? So Macedon, Red Julii and Greek cities, everything else is enemy troops. Alright, so you can see there, the enemy are really closing in on my surrounded Greek city units here, okay? So you've got all the Carthage sacred bandments pushing in on me. I've got Scipioi infantry pushing in on me as well, okay? There's other Carthage sacred band units that you can bring in as well. And as I say, look at our Julii allies. Luckily, we've still got our two Julii generals left there, giving a morale bonus. But as you can see here, a heck of a lot of our Julii allies have now been routed. Okay. Let's say, look at those Carthage sacred band pushing in on me there. Uh-oh, that's one of our allies' generals just been taken out. I think that's Aurelius' general unit has just been killed. So luckily Spearman's still got his general left and he's charging in there to try and help me. But as you can see, my Spartans there are getting surrounded there by enemy troops. You can see those Carthage sacred band really pushing in on my troops there. Okay, so I've got to turn units to face a threat. Okay, everywhere there they're coming in on me, I've turned units to face a threat there. Okay, so that's what you need to do. As I say, I've got my Julii ally there charging in there with the units that he's got left. But as I say, Carthage sacred band cavalry could charge in there. You've got an infantry unit could charge in there as well. As I say, you've got more enemy cavalry out there. And if they hit my allies, Julii troops, there's a chance they could rout them. Okay, you can see that infantry unit going in there. Let's say Spearman, as I say, still got his general unit left. See the OTD charging the SBQR cavalry unit in there, and bang, as that charges in there. Plus, you can see the enemy cavalry starting to charge in there as well. I say, I'm going forward here. I'm trying to get that Carthage general. Those of you that watch our battle videos will know I'm going for that Carthage general with my Greek city units. But as you can see here, I'm being pressed in from all sides here from the enemy. But I'm still going for that Carthage general unit there. I need to take him out if I can. Take the general morale bonus away from the enemy team. Right, you can see here the enemy are targeting my Julii ally with cavalry and infantry there. Okay, they've only got battle damaged cavalry units there, but they can still make a difference because my Julii allies units are battle damaged as well. As I say, you can see my Greek cities still moving forward. The bulk of my troops I'm taking forward. They're trying to take out that Carthage general. But make no mistake, I'm facing units against the enemy attack from all sides coming in on me. Okay, our Julii allies, a general's just been taken out. Okay, bad news for us, but I've managed to rout the Carthage general at the same time there. Okay, but look, Spearman's got 7 men left in that unit. And I think he's got, 10 men in that unit. And that's all of my allies left now, is one unit with 7 and one unit for 10 men there. They fought extremely well, but that's all they've got left. As you can see now, I'm turning direction of attack now, moving towards these Scipioi infantry there with my Greek cities. I'd like to take out that Scipioi general if I could. I've got Carthage sacred band pushing in on me here. You can see OTD Penn there, still alive. After everything we've done to him, he's still got units alive. So he's done really well there with his army. As I say, really pushing in here on to the enemy Scipioi general. I really want to take him out right now. I need to change direction. For me, I think those Carthage sacred band coming in from behind me are the danger. So I'm now going to turn direction there with my Greek cities and attack those Carthage sacred band units that are coming in on me there. Okay, but make no mistake, I'm also facing units against those enemy Scipioi infantry pushing in on my flank as well here. Okay, so really pushing in here on those Carthage sacred band units. You see that cavalry charging, and bang, as that sacred band cavalry charge into the flank of my Greek city units there. And it looks like our team has gone on to win the battle here. But that's all the troops I've got left. And I think I've got one ally left there. Spearman's got one Julii unit left with 8 men in. That's all the men he's got left. So out of all of our team, Spearman's just got 8 infantry left in one unit. And I've just got very battle damaged Spartans. So that goes to show how much this was a real battle of attrition. And this was quite a spread out battle as well. If we go right over to our left flank here, remember we saw that big cavalry attack there where all the a lot of the enemy cavalry were involved there, and our Macedonian ally and our Julii cavalry allies come over there to help. If you move across this part of the back, you can see there's been some skirmishing and some dead archers in certain places here. As we move across the battlefield here, more skirmishing here. And then as we move from the skirmished area over to the mass battle area here, and you can now see the piles of dead. This is obviously where the most intense part of the fighting was here. As you can see here, we just move across. It's like a carpet of dead here. Just goes to show and bears testament to how this was a real battle of attrition here, and how intense it was in this particular part of the battlefield. But as I say, I think that OTD pen held extremely well on our right flank. I remember at the time when we played this battle, we thought, oh my gosh, what are we going to have to do to kill him? Because he was lasting so long there, we were sending so many resources over to try and take him out, and yet he was still holding. Okay? And that just goes to show what an experienced stripe can do for your infantry. Keep you fighting longer. And of course, he had his general unit there with those 8 upgrades on. We're giving a morale bonus all the time there. But as I say, it looks like our team has has managed to go on to win the battle. As I say, you can see my general there, still alive. Still got 32 men left in that unit, so I'm pleased that managed to keep the general alive there. Always important in battle, if you can keep your general alive, obviously, to give that general morale bonus to your troops there, keep them fighting longer. Okay. So the first thing I'd like to say is really well played to everybody in the game there. It was a really close, epic, classic battle, guys. And as you can see there, as I say, a close victory there. So say really well played to everybody in the game there. Highest kills, I've managed to scrape in the highest kills with that old Greek city's army of mine. So I'm pleased with that. But I'd just like to show you something else very interesting here. The second highest kills, third highest kills and fourth highest kills all go to the enemy team. So really well done to them. That just goes to show how close this battle was. Second, third and fourth highest kills in the game. So really well done to the enemy team there. As I say, it's quite unusual that. So really well done to OTT Baron there. Got some good kills and he held extremely well on that right flank. As I say, we were hitting him with everything and he was still holding. But that just goes to show what good upgrades can do for your troops there. So well done to him. Well done to Barclayman. Got some good kills there as well. Did extremely well with his Carthage, his Sacred Band, cavalry and infantry. Well done to Uther. Probably didn't get the kills that he wanted to do there, but he very rarely uses Carthage. So he still probably got experimental army there. And well done to Trajan, got some really good kills there as well. So really well played, guys. Great battle there, and it was just a bit of luck I think we won that. Well done to Brotherhood member Crypto, got some great kills there with his Macedonians there. Doesn't use them very often, but he did well with them. Well done to Spearman, all over the battlefield, supporting all over the battlefield there. Great battlefield awareness. And well done to Aurelius. Probably didn't get the kills that he wanted, but he was also a great support player. Great battlefield awareness there as well. So really well done. Quick look at the statistics of my Greek cities. I've got to see 1 unit kill, 147, 1 unit kill, 14. Not great kills there, I don't think, really. Not particularly good there, but I suppose they did okay. So once again, really well played to everybody in the game. I thought it was nice to see several different factions involved here. So you can see like Greek cities, Macedon and Rome there in one team. And then you got Rome to Carthage and Rome in the other team there. So I hope you enjoyed this battle. Look forward to seeing you soon. And bye for now.